Good morning everyone, myself Mohammad Aleem, I am from EC department. Today I am going to explain about digital to analog converter. Here are the subtopics which we are dealing in this video. Introduction to digital to analog converter and its application, weighted resistor digital to analog converter, and the last one is R2R ladder digital to analog converter. Before going to digital to analog converter, let us know what is analog and what is digital. What is analog? It is a device or system that represents changing values as continuously variable physical quantities, example wall clock, or it may be defined as it means something that has an output that's proportional or similar to its input, usually a voltage. What is digital? It is a data or information represented in binary like zeros and one. Here are the waveform of analog and digital. Real world is analog, and analog waves are smooth and continuous. Then coming to digital, computer is digital, and digital waves are stepping, square and discrete. Introduction to digital to analog converter. When talking about signal, they can be broadly classified into analog signal and digital signal. All electronic like logic gates, flip-flop, microcontroller, etc. work with digital signal, while the analog electronic like op-amp, power switches, etc. in typical electronics design, these two signal often have to be converted from one form to another form. In the field of electronic, digital to analog digital to analog converter is a type of system that is used for the conversion of digital signal into analog signal, while the analog to digital converter behave a reverse of it. Let us take an example. If we take the illustration of given digital system, the analog to digital converter will convert the analog data, like the data that is used being collected as the audio input such as microphone, to digital signal that will be processed by the computer. Now after the conversion from ADC, that is analog to digital, the digital to analog converter, the digital sound signal of the speaker back into the analog signal that is usable by the speaker as a output equipment. Then coming to what is digital to analog converter. In electronics, it is referred as DAC or D2A. It is a system that converts a digital signal into analog signal, or it may be defined as it converts a binary value like zeros and one to a set of continuously analog voltages. A DAC inputs a binary number and outputs an analog voltage or current signal. Here are the block diagram of digital to analog converter. Here we are giving a binary input like zeros and one, and the output is in the form of analog voltage or current. General concept of digital to analog converter. A digital to analog converter conversion involves transforming the computer binary outputs in zeros and one into an analog representation of the binary data. Then coming to resolution. Resolution is nothing but the minimum possible change at the output for the digital to analog converter for any change in input in digital input. Or resolution is usually referred to as step size, since it was a total change in Vout when the digital input changes from one step to the next step. Here step size is considered as resolution. For that, what we are doing is we are giving digital data, it will convert into analog data. Here step size can be taken as LSB. For nth bit, resolution is equals to V out by 2 power n minus 1, where V out is equals to output voltage and n is equals to number of bit. Percentage resolution is equals to step size by FSO into 100, where FSO is equals to full scale output voltage. FSO is equals to 2 power n minus 1 into step size. By substituting in above step, we get step size by 2 power n minus 1 into step size. Here step size and step size get cancelled, and we left by 1 by 2 power n minus 1 into 100. Percentage resolution is equals to 1 by 2 power n minus 1 into 100. Let us take an example. Find out the percentage resolution of a DAC for n bits, hence determine the value of n is equals to 12. Formula for percentage resolution is equals to 1 by 2 power n minus 1 into 100. For n is equals to 12, Here substitute n is equals to 12 in above step. We get 1 by 2 power n minus 1 into 100. By simplifying this step, we get 0.2044 and percentage resolution is equals to 244 ppm, that is parts per million. Utilization of digital to analog converter. As we know, computer is a binary machine operating in an analog world. So to be able to produce an analog output that is understandable by other devices, a DAC is used. Example: a computer stores audio in the form of binary values of the sound wave. In order to play then these back as sound on a speaker, we need analog signal because as we know the speaker diaphragm vibrates based on the intensity of the analog signal to produce sound or music. So here we will use DAC to convert the digital audio file into analog signal in order to play it on a speaker. Application of DAC. DAC are commonly used in music player to convert digital data stream into analog audio signal. They are also used in television and mobile phone to convert video data into analog video signal. Example like it is used in digital control system and it is used in computer printers. It is used in digital audio, example like CD, MP3 players. It is used in function generator wave like sinusoidal wave, square wave, triangular wave, etc. Types of DAC. Here are the types of DAC: binary weighted resistor, R2R ladder, multiplier DAC, and the last one is non-multiplier DAC. Among them, binary weighted resistor and R2R ladder are commonly used. Binary weighted resistor. It is a classification of DAC. So here this binary weighted resistor is also going to convert any digital data into analog form. So here is the circuit diagram for binary weighted resistor. As the name indicates, it's having binary weights of resistor, that means 2R, 2 square R, so on, 2 power NR. For example, if you want to convert 4 bit data, you are having up to only 2 power 4R. Like if you want to convert n bit data to analog form, then you are having up to 2 power NR. So we are giving digital data as input as ports on A1, A2, AN. So here we can see a reference voltage VR. And here we can observe an op amp with negative feedback, that is feedback resistance. So whatever resistance taking, that is equal to RF. Here are the switch. If your digital data is 1, it is connected to A1 bit. If your digital data is 0, then it is connected to ground. For example, we are having 3 bit data, that is 100. Here MSB is equals to 1, that is most significant bit is equals to 1. Like here this switch is connected to A1 and rest of them is connected to ground. The resultant circuit look like this. Here output voltage is equals to minus RF by RI into VI, where VI is equals to input voltage, RI is the input resistance and RF is feedback resistance. Here minus RF by RI is equals to 2R and VI is equals to minus VR. So minus minus get cancelled and RF get cancelled. So output voltage is equals to VR by 2. For example, for n is equals to 1, that is LSB is equals to 1. So consider AN is equal to LSB. Here this switch is connected to AN and rest of them all switches is connected to ground. So V out is equals to minus RF by RI into VI. So input resistance is 2 power NR and in input voltage is minus VR. Minus RF by 2 power n RF into minus VR. Minus minus get cancelled, RF get cancelled. So output voltage is equals to VR by 2 power n. So the final expression for this binary weighted resistor DAC is V out is equals to a1 by 2 plus a2 by 2 square plus a3 by 2 cube plus so on a in so on an by 2 power n into VR. Here a1, a2, a3 and an are the bits of digital data, and VR is a reference voltage which we are giving, and V0 is equals to output voltage. Advantages of binary weighted resistor: it is simple analysis and it is fast conversion. Disadvantages: this setup requires a wide range of actual values of resistor. It require low switch resistance in transistor. It is usually limited to 8 bit resolution. For example, if we are sending 30 bits, then for LSB we need to consider 2 power 30. That is very big value of resistance. So it is very typical to consider that much range of resistance. That is a disadvantage of binary weighted resistor. R2R ladder. So what is an R2R ladder? It is a just clearly arranged set of resistors that gives the unique action of turning binary signal into an analog output voltage. In binary weighted DAC, in which we are got some disadvantage, like in case of more number of bits, you need to maintain the more resistant value and more range of resistance. It is typical in practice. That's why we are switching to R2R ladder, in which we will use only the resistance of value of R and 2R. Whereas binary weighted resistor DAC, the resistance value are dependent upon the number of bit. So the number of bit goes on increasing, the resistance value that we are taking, the resistance value that we are taking also increasing. That is a problem when more number of bits are there. But here, whatever may be the number of bits that we are converting from digital to analog, so not dependent on that. This is going to use only R and 2R values resistor. So now you can see the circuit diagram of R2R ladder. The main difference between binary weighted resistor and R2R ladder is, in binary weighted resistor we use 2R, 2 square R, 2 power n R, and in R2R ladder we use parallel resistance as 2R, and series resistance we include extra compared to binary weighted resistor DAC. So series resistance considering as R and parallel resistance considering like 2R. And A1, A2, A3 are the bits of digital data. Here MSB is equals to most significant bit, and LSB is equals to least significant bit. Now coming to operation of R2R ladder DAC, we need just modify the problem in binary weighted resistor DAC, but we need to get the same output that we are getting or not. So our digital data that we are providing here, A1, A2 places are there that we are giving our binary data. Let us take an example. We are having 3-bit binary data, A1 is equals to 1, A2 and A3 is equals to 0. This switch is connected to A1, that is MSB, and rest of them all switches is connected to ground. So the resultant circuit look like this. Here these two resistance are in parallel, so the parallel resistance equivalent is 2R into 2R by 2R plus 2R is equals to 4R square by 4R. Here 4 and 4 get cancelled, square and R get cancelled, we get R. So modifying this circuit, we get like this. Again here R and R in series, we need to add them. Now these 2R and these 2R are in parallel, so the equivalent parallel resistance is R. Now in this circuit we are having this resistor in series. We get, by adding these two resistor we get 2R. So now this 2R is parallel with this 2R reference voltage. We need to apply Thevenin's voltage formula. Here VTH is equals to minus VR into 2R by 2R plus 2R. We get minus VR into 2R by 4R. VTH is equals to minus VR by 2R. Now RTH means 2R parallel with 2R, so we get R. Now the resultant circuit is here. Again these two R and R are in series. Simple we have to add them. Here is the final circuit. So now you can have input resistance and input voltage for your negative feedback op amp, and you are having feedback resistance. Formula for output voltage is equals to minus RF by RI into VI. Here RF is equals to feedback resistance and RI is equals to input resistance, VI is equals to input voltage. Now RF is equals to 3I and RI is equals to input resistance, which we are having 3I into input voltage. Input voltage is equals to minus VR by 2. Minus minus get cancelled, 3R get cancelled. So the final answer is V naught is equals to VR by 2. Same voltage we got in binary weighted resistor. Here are the advantage of R2R ladder. Number of bits can be expanded by adding more section of same R and 2R values. In R2R ladder, it is only two values of resistor R and 2R, so it is easy to select and design more accurate resistor. Disadvantage of R2R ladder, it is lower conservation speed than binary weighted DAC also, that is the digital to analog converter. Thank you, stay safe, stay home.